A fully automated biochemistry analyzer is designed to measure biochemical parameters quickly with minimal human assistance. The purpose of this analyzer is to reduce human errors, handle increased sample load, and provide accurate results more efficiently. They are used to determine the concentration of various biochemical analytes, metabolites, enzymes, electrolytes, drug levels, etc., in samples of serum, plasma, urine, cerebrospinal fluid, and other body fluids. Biochemistry analyzers can be of two types: benchtop model or the floor model. Technical specifications. Let us first understand the important technical systems of a biochemistry autoanalyzer. The aspiration system. It includes sample aspiration probe, which has a programmed peristaltic pump to aspirate predetermined sample volume. Reagent aspiration probe has a programmed peristaltic pump to aspirate exact volume of reagent. Wash nozzles for flow cell wash after every test sample. Air wash for drying the cuvettes after each sample. Optical system. It includes the light source, which is tungsten or tungsten halogen lamp for polychromatic light. Wavelength selector, like filters or prism to give specific wavelength of monochromatic light. Flow cell or cuvettes, where reactions take place. Photodetector in form of photovoltaic or barrier layer cell, which calculates the absorbance. Measurement system. Measurement system includes reagent blanking and auto zero setting before calibration. Calibration of analytes against standard with saving of new calibration factors. Optical density measurement. Temperature maintenance of reaction vessels and reagent compartment. Three pillars for quality to ensure accuracy of results. It includes the preventive maintenance, calibration, and control. Preventive maintenance. Analyzer maintenance is performed according to the manufacturer's instructions. Usually, the machine gives reminders of the schedule of maintenance that need to be followed. Maintenance involves regular check of the aspiration system, optical system, and measurement system, replacement of parts undergoing wear and tear, protocols for daily, weekly, monthly, and yearly maintenance as per manufacturer's guideline. Records of all maintenance carried out should be kept. Calibration of machine done by the company engineers for the measurable parts like aspiration probes, temperature, etc., and optical parts like photodetectors and light source at regular intervals. Calibration of analytes done by technicians for all analytes at scheduled intervals during lot change and post-maintenance or repair of instruments. Controls. Internal quality control samples are run on daily basis before patient sample and following preventive maintenance or repair of machine. External quality control samples are run usually on a monthly basis. General guidelines to be followed. Before using an automated instrument, proper training of all users is carried out. Read the user's manual and create a specific workflow and maintenance protocol for the lab. Read the product inserts for all reagent calibrators and controls. Check their expiry dates and storage instructions. Run all necessary calibrations and controls before patient sample as specified by the regulatory agencies. Document the results of performance and corrective actions taken. Reach out to the manufacturer for technical assistance as required. Please refer to the training module on equipment management. Parts of a biochemistry analyzer and their functions. sample tray. Sample tray is used to keep samples. The samples may be either presented in sample cups or in primary sample tubes. The analyzer may have onboard barcode reading capacity or manual entry of sample ID. Sampling probe. Sampling probe aspirates sample in conjunction with sample syringe from a sample container and dispenses it into a cuvette. Cuvette wheel. Cuvette wheel houses glass cuvettes where measured volume of reagent and sample is delivered for reaction to occur and absorbance readings are taken. The cuvettes are either made of quartz glass, plastic, or disposable one-time use, or disposable refrigerator. Refrigerated compartment which houses reagents to ensure integrity of reagents. Reagent probe aspirates and dispenses reagent. Reagent probe aspirates syringe into glass cuvettes located in the cuvette wheel. Mix bar component. Mix bar component houses spiral-shaped and L-shaped mix bar that mix the reagents and sample dispensed into the cuvette. Photometer lamp. Component of the photometric system that is used to measure reactions. Cuvette wash station. Cuvette wash station is used to wash the cuvettes after the tests have been performed. The washing is carried out automatically. It cleans, rinses, and dries cuvettes after analysis. At the end of the wash cycle, cuvettes are ready for the next test. Stat positions. Stat positions are used to process urgent samples while the regular tests are being analyzed. Machine is programmed to pick samples from these positions first. Tank storage area. The tank storage area houses the deionized water tank, wash solution tank, and diluted wash solution tank used to clean cuvettes, mix bars, and the rinse component. Regular cleaning of this water tank and filters is very important. Failure to do so may give rise to mold, which in turn can grow up till the probes. For details on the cleaning process, get in touch with your service engineer. Deionization water plant. The tap water is the feed water to the machine and it is processed through the deionization plant. The final analytical water is type 2 water with resistivity more than 1 and conductivity less than 1 Siemen per meter, as per the American Society for Testing and Materials. These two parameters should be checked daily and documented. If using commercially purchased deionized water, conductivity and resistivity can be checked by a handheld device. This is very important for the measurement of certain electrolytes like calcium, magnesium, and phosphorus. Multiple pictograms depicted on the machine issue warnings against certain actions that need to be avoided. Pay heed to these warnings. Daily startup procedure. The daily startup procedure includes set the start conditions, perform daily analyzer maintenance, check the analyzer status, check and replenish reagents, perform analyte calibration, process quality control. Set start condition. Start the analyzer by switching on. Once the computer screen opens, feed in username and password. The date and time of running the test and the operator name. Check the temperature of the reagent compartment and the cuvette. Check the supply of distilled water. Usually, anything which is out of the normal will be indicated by color-coded alert button. Daily analyzer maintenance. Maintenance should be performed on the analyzer to ensure system performance and safety. Daily analyzer maintenance involves a series of inspections and replenishment of solutions. A maintenance schedule list which acts both as a reminder and as a documented proof of the maintenance should be prepared as per the equipment user manual and pasted near the analyzer. They more or less include checking all syringes for leaks, visual inspection for any cracks or leaks or condensation, verifying if they are screwed tightly, inspecting the wash solution, its pump and tubings. Visually inspect the pump and tubings for any cracks or leaks. Check if the solution is enough for the day's use. Replenish if needed. Inspect and clean the sample probe, reagent probe, and mix bars. Wipe the exterior of the probes with a lint-free cloth dipped in 70% alcohol. Using a lint-free cloth is important to avoid leaving any residual fibers on the probes. Also ensure that the probe is not disaligned while cleaning. Verify the proper operation of the probes by programming the rotation of the probe. It should move sideways and then come back to its original location. Check if a thin stream of water is dispensed from each probe. Manual cleaning of the sample probe may be required to remove microclots and fibrin deposits. These deposits will decrease the aspiration volume and produce false results. Unscrew the probe carefully and, using a syringe, dispense deionized water through it. Wipe it with a lint-free cloth and screw it back carefully. Assess the cleanliness of the cuvette, as dirt, scratches, or fading of your cuvettes can interfere with the test result. Go to the photocal monitor and select any random cuvette. Check its OD or wavelength. Graphical representation of different wavelengths should be within acceptable limits. Any variation will give an indication for the need for change of the photolamp or cuvette. Inspect the printer and paper if it is enough for the day's use. Check the analyzer status. The analyzer status menu displays a color-coded overview of the system and the temperatures of the incubator and reagent refrigerator. The easy color-coded visual aids indicate the status of the components. For example, blue is no errors, analyzer can be started. Yellow is non-fatal error, the analyzer can be started. Red is fatal error, the analyzer cannot be started. The stat table, deionized water tank, wash solution tank, waste tank, printer, and the LIS communication are also monitored similarly. Check and replenish reagents. A reagent check should be performed during a daily startup to determine the number of tests on board and to update the status of the reagents. From the user menu screen, check for reagent blank to check for reagent quality and stability, reagent volume for adequacy so the processing of sample is not interrupted in the middle of the day, date of expiry of the reagents. Verify the lot number and bottle number whenever a new reagent is added. Check for reagent calibration. This is explained later in detail. Perform analyte calibration. During a reagent check, the system automatically orders reagent blank and calibration check for all parameters. Calibrate the analytes requiring calibration. Calibrators are materials with known values which are traceable to the SI unit through an unbroken chain of comparisons. Reagents contain reactive ingredients which may deteriorate over time, altering the degree of reaction to the same concentration of analyte. A calibration readjusts the current reactive potency of the reagent to the calibrator value by deriving a calibration factor. If the reagent storage is good, the calibration factor will stable till the expiry of the reagent. Based on the stability of the reagents, the manufacturer will recommend a separate schedule for each analyte. Usually, labile reagents have a shorter calibration interval. Also, the equipment undergoes wear and tear, and changes in the environmental conditions can also cause variation in the results. For more details, refer to the training module on equipment management. Monitoring of calibration is important. This screen shows you two important factors, reagent history or reagent blank. A reagent blank will tell how the reagent is preserved. Reagent calibration history will tell how much readjustment the reagent needed while in use. It is important to monitor the performance of each lot of reagent, and therefore calibration is required when a new lot of reagent is put into use. The calibrator must be stored as per manufacturer's instruction to maintain its integrity. Multiple pictograms on the vial indicate the storage and handling conditions given by the manufacturer. Reconstitution of calibrator. Take out the vial of calibrator from the refrigerator and bring it to room temperature. Open the vial and place the cap on the workbench gently. Notice the calibrator powder adhering to the inside of the cap. As calibrators are expensive and last for a short duration, use them judiciously. Reconstitute the calibrator with 5 ml of injection water. Close the cap and mix gently by inversion. Keep it for 10 minutes and then mix again. Wait for another 10 minutes, mix and then distribute the reconstituted calibrator into aliquots and label them. Store these aliquots in the freezer from minus 10 to minus 20 degrees centigrade. Run one aliquot at a time for calibration. Remove from the freezer, thaw, and use and discard the rest.
Check the calibration curve and the calibration factor.
Process quality control. Once the calibration process is completed, we proceed to running of controls to validate the newly calibrated analytes as well as the existing valid calibrations. A quality control product is a patient-like material ideally made from human serum. A control product can be in a liquid or lyophilized form and is composed of one or more constituents of known concentration. Control products are tested in the same manner as patient samples. For biochemistry, we use quality control product containing different analytes. They can be of normal or abnormal levels. A normal control contains analytes in the normal biological reference range, while the abnormal control product contains the analyte at a concentration above or below the normal reference range for the analyte. Quality control results are used to validate whether the instrument and reagents are operating within predefined specifications, inferring that patient results are reliable. Procedure to run quality control. Quality control should be run daily as a routine for all analytes being tested. Quality control should also be run after an analyte is calibrated.
After reagent lot change. After major maintenance activity.
At least two levels of quality control should be run, including a normal level and an abnormal level. The quality control kit insert contains the lot number, expiry date, mean values, and the standard deviation limits for all analytes. Define the quality control in machine and run the quality control.
Each lab should have a procedure for determining its own mean and standard deviation values for quality control samples. Manufacturer values may serve as a rough guide in the initial period.
Reconstitution of control. The control sample is analyzed after the startup procedure. The controls are in lyophilized form and reconstituted before use. Using a calibrated volumetric pipette, reconstitute the control with commercially available 5 ml of deionized water vial. Allow the control to stand for 30 minutes at room temperature, swirling intermittently. Prepare aliquots as per requirement and label them with lot number and date of expiry. For testing, take out single vial. Mix the vial several times to ensure homogeneity and remove the stopper before sampling. Retain the control sample in aliquots at -10 to -20 degrees centigrade for further use. Once thawed, do not refreeze or reuse the control. In an automated equipment, all the quality control values get stored as data points and are plotted on the Levy-Jennings chart. The data points need to be evaluated within the defined standard deviation to be a valid run. If the values are outside the acceptable range, corrective action needs to be taken. For more information on calibration and quality control, refer to the Labs for Life quality control tool. When the control values of all the analytes are found to be within the acceptable ranges, proceed to processing the sample for the day. Operating steps for processing samples. Place the sample rack with samples on the rack feeder module. Press start. The rack is moved to the barcode reader where sample is programmed or identified. The rack then moves to the sample aspiration position. The reagent probe with the reagent syringe delivers R1 reagent and diluent into a cuvette. R1 bar mixes the diluted reagent in the cuvette. The photometer measures absorbance of the reagent. The sample probe with the sample syringe aspirates and dispenses sample into the cuvette in a cuvette wheel. A sample mix bar mixes the sample and the reagent. The photometer continues to take readings. If required, the reagent probe with reagent syringe delivers the R2 reagent and the diluents into the cuvette. R2 mix bar mixes the reaction mixture. The photometer continues to take reaction reading. The cuvette is then washed, rinsed, and dried by the wash nozzle probes using diluted wash solution and deionized water. The result will be shown on the screen. Interpretations of result. Review the result. Result can lie within the normal reference range, lower or higher than the reference range.
Review the result in the context of calibration, internal and external QC results, measurement uncertainty, etc. to ascertain its validity. Correlate with previous lab reports and clinical features of the patient.
If there is any flag, go through the flag list provided by the manufacturer and take corrective action accordingly. All the results of the patient should be correlated as far as possible.